Hello there, all you amazing people. We are doing a little bit of experiment. We are running Windows 10 on a 1-core, 1-gig system. You heard me right, 1-core, 1-gig. This is not a physical computer, this is a VM, but it also shows what the capability of Windows actually is. So if we go in here and we right click here, we do task manager, and yes, it is slow. It's really slow. Like, look, it's really slow. This is something that you and I would never be okay with. And you can see here, we are maxing out the computer. I don't even know how much stuff we can run, so let's open stuff here and see what's happening. But it shows you what you can actually do. Like how, well, not well, you guys can see, we are opening up the good old Microsoft Store here. We are opening up our file manager when it kind of wants to get to this. And you, again, it's slow, it's a bad experience. We can see here, it's struggling. It's like me trying to run a fucking marathon. It's already, you know, yelling and screaming, please stop torturing me, don't do this to me, I'm an innocent little system, don't do it to me. This is not a usable experience. We're still waiting for good old fucking Edge to open up, by the way, and I can see there is updates going on here. There's probably also updates in the background if you go into the settings manager, if it can even open up. Oh, Edge is coming up there, I think. Come on. And you guys and girls can see, this is not an experience you want. You don't want this experience. But is it running? Yeah. Let's see if you can actually see what is Windows 10 minimum requirements. Let's see what that is. I'm doing stuff right now on Windows 10 in a 1 core, 1 gigabyte of RAM session here. And it's downloading and upgrading in the back end. This, like, I will not recommend anyone doing this, but I'm trying to prove a point here. I thought I saw it said 1 gigahertz or something like that, but is it dual core or quad core? I couldn't really see it. So 1 gigahertz or faster. 1 gig of RAM or 2 gigabyte for 54 gig. That's what I'm running it on. So Windows 10 and Ubuntu 22.04 has the same minimum requirements. Let's run Mint with the same requirements. I'm going to kill this VM here. Give me a second. So now we are booting up Linux Mint with 1 core and 1 gig of RAM. Oh, sorry, Ubuntu Cinnamon Edition. Ubuntu Cinnamon Edition. I will say it boots up faster than Windows did. So let's open up. I clicked a thing. Oh, okay, now it's yeah, it's slow. Can we do, like, is it called system monitor? Yeah, it's hard to say if it's running. Is it running? It's again, I don't have much open here, but it's hard to say how much faster it's actually running than good old Windows 10. Maybe a maybe I'm getting like 10% better performances. They're about I haven't run a proper benchmark, of course, but that's what it feels like. But it feels just as slow as on the Windows 10, to be honest. So let's open up Wikipedia, let's open up Reddit, let's open up Twitter, let's do an update. It you guys can see it's almost as fucking unbearable to use. It's really as unbearable to use. You will not be happy running Linux like this. I will not be happy running Linux like this. Yeah, this is I will say this, it is a little bit faster than the Windows 10. But not so much faster that would be like, yep. If I had a 1-core system with 1 gig of RAM, I would definitely running Linux. No, had I had a 1-core system and a 1 gig of RAM system, I would not run any of these operating systems. they are just as unbearable. We are still waiting for the fucking dependency tree to build here. We have 9 packages to upgrade. It's like I can't barely. Look how long it takes before it registers anything. I'm clicking. There you go. Yeah, this is just not usable. Just like Windows. I'm not knocking Linux here. I actually set out to see first if I could run Windows on a 1 gig, 1 core system. And yes, I could. Because people in my comment section said I could not. They didn't believe me saying that I was running Windows 10 on a 10-year-old machine at work. Look, if you're running Linux with a modern desktop, and this is Cinnamon. Is not that resource hungry. Had I run GNOME? Have I run KDE with all the bells and whistles? Maybe if I run XFCE, I would have a little bit of a better experience. Maybe if I ran Mate. Yes, again, if I was running an i3 or Tiling Windows machine, I would have a way better experience. If I was running no UI at all, I would have a better experience. But we also have to remember, when we are comparing Linux to Windows, you cannot compare Windows with its full-blown UI to an i3 install of whatever installation you have. That's not apples to apples. That's two way different things. You have to set up Linux the same way that the user using Windows, if they were going to Linux, how would they run their system? A Windows user would not go to Linux and run an i3 environment. Or well, most of them would not do that. So you have to put in a full-blown desktop environment, because that's what 9 out of 10 Linux people are running. They're running some form of this here. And I think we can all agree upon that, I click and drag here, that this is like, yeah, this is useless. It's just a little bit less useless than Windows. So you can run Windows on a 1 gigabyte of RAM and 1 core, and you can run Linux on 1 gigabyte and 1 core system. For the love of everything you believe in, don't ever do it if you're going to run anything other than a text editor. I hope this makes sense. See you all later. Bye bye.